Tell me about the pronunciation of your book.
Well, a lot of people have been saying Belzhar, but okay. I answer to that too, you know. But it's Belzhar, which is kind of a play on the title, The Belzhar by Sylvia Plath, which figures into the book.
In the introduction of your book, you say, I'll paraphrase it, young YA readers are lucky to be at the beginning of everything. And what did you mean by that?
I remember so much being a young teenager and just discovering all kinds of books for the first time and being shocked by what was in them. I don't mean graphic content, but just the world, that people were writing about things that I thought about and maybe were hadn't, you know, verbalized to anyone yet, feelings that you think you're the only one who has them. Other people actually have them, writers, and have put them down, and that's thrilling. And I read so much. I would go to the library. My mother is a writer, and they let us take out more books than anyone else. I felt very important. And my mother's, you know, would take me to the library, and I would just get this enormous stack of books, and I would go through them one after another, and they stuck. That was the thing. The books that you read when you come of age, you know, matter forever.
And tell me a little, just like a little description of the book.
Well, Belzhar is about a girl named Jam Gallahue who has experienced a tragic loss of her boyfriend. And she's sent to a boarding school called the Wooden Barn in Vermont because she can't quite get over what's happened to her. And it's a school for emotionally fragile, highly intelligent teenagers. And when she's there, she's put in a special English class called Special Topics in English. And they're each given a copy of The Belzhar by Sylvia Plath to read and a red leather journal. And when they write in the journals, the students in the class, they're sort of transported to another place where their yearnings and things that they've lost are returned to them. And it's really, for me, about those feelings that happen in adolescence, the unbearable, and how you perceive things and how you get over them. And it was a pleasure to write.
In the story, Jam talks about Charlotte's Web as the first book that she related to herself.
Yes.
Is that an autobiographical detail, or do you have another book?
Oh, you know me. Yes, it is. I did read Charlotte's Web with my mother, and I have never gotten over the death of that spider. And that's the thing about fiction. I mean, because my mother's a writer, as I said, writing and books were so important in my household, as they are, of course, in my current household. And to give someone, you know, your kid, a book that you love and just wait in anticipation for them to read it, it's sort of like when you cook a meal for your kid and you know that it's good, you kind of hover over their plate to see if they like it. And my mother did that, I think, with Charlotte's Web, and I remember sobbing at the book because the characters are made so alive. It's a spider and a pig, but they are, you know, you can imagine yourself needing to save the life of Wilbur. I feel a lot when I read a book that feels emotionally true. You know, it's like I walk around changed for the rest of the day. I've had that feeling. And like also like you don't want to go away from the book. Even when I'm writing, I'll send myself the pages and I'll sort of look at them on my phone because I want to stay with the characters. And I was doing that quite a bit when I was writing Belzhar.
Were there any parts that you looked at later, you know, when you reread them on your phone and sort of decided you needed to change anything major or?
Well, originally it was set on Pluto. No, it was not. Of course, yes, I changed a lot. Revision is so incredibly important. I think that the nuances of character really come about in revision. There's a teacher in the book, Mrs. Q, who is a very important figure. And I kind of worked with her personality a little bit. I had to kind of get to know her. Characters don't arrive for a writer like fully formed, sprung from Zeus's head. You know, they don't. I mean, they take form over time. And the beauty of revision is that you start to see what you meant, and then you see, oh, wait a minute, that wasn't exactly what I meant. She needs to be tougher, or she needs to be kinder. And I think that that is, for me, the pleasure of writing. You know, somebody said, and I'm never sure who, that what we remember of the books we love isn't plot, but character, and I really do believe that.
Mm-hmm. I know that's true. I loved your middle grade novel, Fingertips of Duncan Dorfman. And I also heard that you are, or read that you're a tournament Scrabble player.
Well, not exactly tournament, but I have been in tournaments. I haven't done all that well, but my son was in tournaments on a kid level, and I went with him into that world, and it was so fantastic. It was kids playing Scrabble, kids competing in teams who had never met before, you know, kids meeting up over a Scrabble game, and there was this sort of universality about it, and a great sense of fairness and pleasure in the play. And I looked at that world, and I thought, this is an incredible world to create a novel out of. Mm-hmm. Whenever you find a subculture, there's a novel in it, you know? But I loved writing that book, too.
And I like the way that in both of those books, too, you know, you have these characters that come together from really different places, but yeah, find this wonderful commonality.
That was true, right, in my novel, The Interestings, the adult novel, and that's true in Belzhar, too. I guess I feel that way when you think about your friends. You all have come together from different backgrounds and different places, and I think I just like the idea of recreating that. I mean, I guess there's two kinds of stories. Family stories, because everyone is coming, springing from the same place. And they may be so different. You know that line about how everyone in a family has a different set of parents? Mm-hmm. I love that because it's true. You are unique to yourself, but you're living under the same roof. Whereas when you come from all different places, like go to college or go to a boarding school or a summer camp, whatever it is, or meet up at a Scrabble tournament, everyone brings an entirely different history. And I think that that's ripe for fiction because it's that moment of meeting and maybe combustion that makes a book.